Once upon a time, a long time ago, a little girl called Mary lived in a faraway country called Wales with her mom and dad. They did not have a lot of money. There was no school close to where Mary lived, and so she had not learnt to read or write. Every Sunday, Mary went to church with her parents. There, she would listen to the minister read from the big Bible. Mary loved listening to the amazing stories about people like Noah and his ark, David and Goliath, and the miracles of Jesus. Mary tried really hard to remember all the stories the minister read in church, but it was too difficult. One day, Mary's dad came home with wonderful news. A school was opening in their village. "I can finally learn to read and write," thought Mary. "Now I can read the Bible stories myself." But in those days, books were very expensive. Mrs. Evans, who lived close by, was lucky enough to have a Bible of her own. She knew how much Mary loved Bible stories. One day, she invited Mary to her house to come and read from her Bible. When Mary went to Mrs. Evans's house, she saw the big Bible on a special table on a beautifully embroidered cloth. "I wish I had a Bible of my own," said Mary. Then and there, she decided to do whatever it took to get a Bible of her own. Mary worked very hard to save money. She gathered wood and eggs and sold them at the market. She mended clothes, and she also did some babysitting. Finally, after 6 years, she had enough money to buy a Bible. But there were no Bibles in her town that she could buy. Mary would have to travel far away to a town called Bala to buy a Bible. In those days, there were no cars or buses. Mary would have to walk. She walked a long, long way all day, about 40 kilometers over rocky mountain paths, barefoot, saving her only pair of shoes for when she arrived in town. Tired and hungry, Mary arrived in Bala just as the sun was disappearing behind the hills. The next morning, Mary raced off to see Reverend Charles, who would sell her a Bible. Mary said excitedly, "I'm here to buy a Bible, so I can read the Bible whenever I want to." Reverend Charles looked at her sadly. "I'm so sorry, my dear," he said, "but I have no more Bibles to sell." Mary was heartbroken. She cried and cried. "But I've come all this way," she said. "I've been saving money for 6 years." Reverend Charles could see how important the Bible was to Mary, and he decided to help her. "Here you go, Mary. You can have one of my very own Bibles," he said. Mary could not believe it when Reverend Charles placed the Bible in her hands. "Oh, thank you, Reverend Charles," she exclaimed. "Thank you, thank you, thank you." A very happy Mary took her Bible home to her parents. Now she didn't have to wait for Sundays in church. She could read the Bible whenever she wanted, and she could share it with other people, just like Mrs. Evans shared her Bible with her. But Mary's story doesn't stop there. Reverend Charles kept thinking about Mary and how difficult it was for her to get a Bible. Later, he went to a meeting where ministers from all over the country were gathered, and he told them Mary's story. All the ministers decided to get more Bibles at low prices for the people of Wales. One of the ministers, Reverend Hughes, stood up and said, "If for Wales, why not for the whole world?" And that is how the first Bible Society started. Today, there are more than 140 Bible societies all over the world who help people like Mary to get Bibles in their own languages.